like why, what is innovation? Why do we have to innovate? How to build an innovative mindset? Okay, I'm assuming that I'm properly audible to all of you. Please, anyone can tell me.
Yes,
like
ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
So today I'm going to focus on innovation. Today I'm going to focus on the term innovation. The other terms I'm going to use during my presentation. Okay, so I'll be talking about innovation, like what is innovation? And it is actually a Latin word that means renew something or to change something. And I'm going to talk about why to innovate, why it is a need to innovate something, and how to build innovative mindset. So we have to start from the first year only. Okay, so I'll be talking about innovations. After that, we have with us Professor Kranti Wagle from Department of Information Technology. And she is the president of Institute's Innovation Council. On the top of this presentation, you can see this logo. You will be seeing this logo in many events which are happening in the college. And if this logo is that, there means that some of the guidelines are provided by this council to the other cells who are organizing the event. Okay, I think you might have understood till now that in our college we are having multiple cells. Like there is an entrepreneur cell, there is a startup cell, there is an IPR cell, or there is a CSI council, that is Computer Society Information, and then there is Code Labs, or there is some SCM council, and every department has different councils. And what the students do is that they are not learning only academics, and during these 4 years, they have to build themselves so that they should be able to perform well when they go out and they start their work, or they join the companies, or they create their own business, or they have to be successful. So during that time, they have to perform, and they need to have multiple qualities, not only academics. So the students, they become this part of the sales, and the sales, they throughout the year, these different e-sales startups, they are organizing events, and events are happening during in the college. Students are organizing the events. Students are participating in the events. And so what is, so Professor Kranti is the president of this council, and she has actually guided many Yantra projects which are handled by IIT, and her projects have got prizes, plus in any other competitions also. So she is also talking to you. After innovation, she will be talking to you about the National Innovation Competition, which is always organized every year by Ministry of Education. Happen in one day. Okay, so what we are trying is that we are having multiple activities within the organization institute throughout the year, so that the students, they get they join, they get trained, and then in the second day, so she'll be talking about what are the different activities which are conducted in the institute, what is this National Innovation Competition, and then we will be providing you a link that you can decide about registering yourself. Okay, so first I'll just spend few minutes on IIC Council, and then I'll start with innovation. Okay, so like here on the right hand side, now you will see the logo. This is UGC, AICT, and Ministry of Education. All three of them, they came together and they formed a cell. They have done some study about how the progress is happening in the educational institutes. And now they want that the student should not learn only the academics. They should get the experience about the outside world, what is happening, businesses and all. And they should have the innovative mindset. Otherwise, it's very difficult to be successful. In order to be successful, it is very, very important to have innovation mindset. Whatever you are doing, whether you are taking a job, or whether you are joining any business, or you are starting your own business, or anything, whatever you do, you have to have innovative mindset. So from that point of view, they formed a group, and that is called as MIC. Okay, the short form is MIC, that is Ministry of Innovation Cell. And our college, we joined that is IICFRCRC. Now you will be able to see, you must be seeing that logo. So this IICFRCRC joined with them. Okay, so our college, we joined with them. Now we get multiple guidelines from them. So we receive, so as a council, it is not a council similar to the other councils in the college. Our council is actually, if we combine all the councils together, we represent IIC. Okay, IIC is a combination of everything which is happening in the institute. It is not a separate cell who is having a special something like, but it is combination of everything. Okay, so we have joined with MIC, and now MIC every year they gives us multiple guidelines. As per the guidelines, we understand about the activities to be performed within the institute, and then we spread this knowledge. We provide this knowledge to ECL, startup cell, or SCM, or code labs, or CSI, and then we perform that activities in the organization for the academic year. Okay, so what is the objective is that we want to build the innovation ecosystem, innovation kind of atmosphere within the college. We need to establish or support startup. Suppose someone wants to start his own business, then he needs some support. So we are there to assist them, to connect them with some other people who will help them or monitor them or guide them, or they will assist them in getting funds and all such kind of things. So to support the startup mechanisms, create an innovative atmosphere within the organization, support startup mechanisms, then let the students come up with multiple ideas, and then pre-incubate the ideas. So pre-incubate the ideas means that you start from idea generation, then come up with the innovation project, and then convert your project into the idea. A project into the product, which can be used by some other people. Okay, maybe like develop like once my students, they developed an application where they took Bandra area, and then they had the Google map, and they built the application which was working for Bandra area, and it was similar to Uber Ola kind of application. But it was only the project. And what is happening in the college is that the students, so such a young mindset and young people who are putting their efforts and doing the projects, and what is happening with the projects is that the projects are stored into the drive, Google Drive or a pen drive, and they are submitting, and then they are leaving the college, and it is remaining over there. Okay, so we just have to take some little bit efforts, and then we have to convert our project into the product in this 4 years, so that you can launch your product, or you should be able to publish it, so that someone who can use the product, it should be usable to someone. Okay, so our objective is to let multiple ideas come from the students and pre-incubate the ideas. So till now we are very, very successful in building the projects. Now the next step is that take some little extra efforts and convert it into the product, so that the students are also beneficial, and they are doing something which is useful to someone in the society. So this is the objective of IIC, and so develop this cognitive ability in the students. That is also a major objective of IIC FRCRC. So I think you must have understood now that IIC FRCRC is a member of MIC. This is a short form of Ministry of Education Innovation Cell. So MIC is the parent body, and then we have attached to MIC, that is called as IIC FRCRC, and we are providing the suggestions and guidelines to other cells, such as ECL, startup cell, or IPR cell, or CSI, or code labs, and they conduct activities throughout the year within the institute. They are having their own activities plus some activities which are suggested by IIC. And this way, multiple activities are happening in the college, and we expect you that you should become a part of the cells to organize the events and to participate in the events, depending on how you are comfortable with. Okay, and every year at the end of the year, this MIC, like we conduct your test, like this, they also conduct our test, and they ask us to show what we have done during the year, and then they give some ratings to us. And I'm glad to share with you that our college has got 4.5 stars out of 5. In the last year. Also, we have joined with this NISP policy, that is National Innovation Startup Policy of this Ministry of Education. And we are working towards having our own rules and regulations about the startups, if the startups are going to come up within the institutes, to how to assist them and how to help them. Okay. This is the link of our college website, IIC website. you can see at the college homepage also there is a link of Institute Innovation Council. You can click on that and you will get to know about multiple details. The site is continuously updated and we are doing the enhancements in the site. So it is also innovations is also happening in the site. We have just built the site. Okay, but the major competitions which are happening every year is about idea competition. We invite the ideas from the students. And once the ideas are approved or once the selected ideas for selected new ideas, we have the another competition called as a proof of concept, that is POC competition, or you can call it as a prototype competition, where students show the demonstration about their idea. Okay, and these are happening in the institute. And about the NIC national level competition, Kranti ma'am is going to tell you in details at the end of my session. Okay, so I think I have given you proper overview about IICFRCRC. IICFRCRC is an innovation cell, and who is providing guidelines and who is conducting as well as asking others to conduct multiple events related to innovations, projects, design thinking. See, whenever you are doing any project, it is not easy at the initial stage. Your design should be proper. You have to know how to think about it, how to identify the opportunities, like how to identify a problem is the first step, and then how to design it. Your design should be correct. You have to identify multiple solutions. You have to select a proper solution, which is an innovative solution and a feasible solution. Like this, there are multiple steps are there. So we are trying that along with the academics. If you join the sessions which are organized by this IICFRCRC along with other cells, you will get to know about all such kind of steps to create a product. Okay, so the steps such as idea, innovation, project to product is called as a pre-incubation stage. If you are doing any project, like first year we don't, there are not much projects, but from second year onwards, for every subject, around every subject, you have to do a mini project. And then in the final year, there will be a final project. So for every subject, if you are building your innovative mindset, you can come up with some good ideas, and then you can show the mini project properly done. Okay. So I think Alvin has raised his hand. You can write down in the chat. At the end, I will take your question. Okay, is it okay? You can write down for your question in the chat box, and I'll ask the host to, or I'll see the chat box and I'll answer your questions. Okay, so keep writing in the chat box. So if it is idea, innovation, project to product is called as a pre-incubation. And then suppose you are very much, you become passionate and you want that, I am thorough with this idea and I want to go ahead. Then you can think about the startups, and if you need any support, then that is called as incubation stage.
Chat box has been disabled. We aren't able to ask questions.
Right now, I cannot give you the control. You write down in the chat box. Okay, so if you go ahead and if you want to go ahead, then you, your project will be in the incubation state. And as per this MOE guidelines, they are saying that even if it is failed, or even if you are not very much interested, and your aim is that you want a dream placement only, because nowadays the students, they talk about the package only, package and dream placements, and that is only there in the mind. So if you are going for the placements, you need to have some experience about having your own startup, and how, what is the procedure, how to get connected with people, and how to establish the network, how to create a product. All such, in your 4 years of journey, you should have at least one experience of creating your own product. Okay. So this is the objective and this is the aim that I have come here to motivate you, and I wish that you are going to contact us whenever you have something in your mind regarding this. Okay, so let's start with the session. Like, what is innovation? Innovation is there is a simple definition about innovation, that creating value. creating value. I think Swapnil has raised the hand. Please, you write down in the chat box. So creating value from ideas. Simple definition of innovation is that you create value from the idea. You have to create multiple ideas, and then that ideas are implemented and it's creating some value. And what kind of value? It can be a value such as a commercial value, like that is going to give you the benefits in terms of money. Or it can be a value that is going to be beneficial to the society, because now people are aware and many people are working to make this Earth planet a good planet to live, and so they are environment friendly and social relevancy is there. Then they want to help poor people or the rural area. They want to help something, and so you must be having some idea, and you want to create. If you're creating the value out of this, it is an innovation. And what is the value? It is a commercial value or generate money. And if you are concentrating with that aim or with that attitude, then it will not be successful. You need to be passionate about your idea, and you should be convinced with the idea, and you should work on that. And then automatically, as a byproduct, it will generate the money. Okay, for you. So in the life also it is happening like that. You have to be passionate about the work that you are doing, and then whatever you want, all the benefits will automatically come with that. Okay, so innovation is a journey. It's a journey or voice towards value creation. It's a journey. It's not you have done something and it is stopped. It is a continuous journey. And it is generated from ideas. This is an example of Google founders, that Larry Page and Brin. They had their idea in their mind that we will have the application like they were in college, like you people. That time they thought about the idea that they will crawl the internet and they will get all the web pages and they will download and then they will keep it in their data center or their server room where all the machines are there, and they will store all the web pages. And people laughed at them. People laughed at their idea. So if you are having multiple ideas and if you are convinced with your idea, you should be convinced so much that you know that from your study and from your inner conscious that it is going to work. And then you may ignore the other people's opinion about it. Okay, and then you can go ahead with that idea. And if you are convinced and if you are passionate, then automatically it is going to happen, and it will come into the product or a service, and that will create the value. So innovation is creating value or from your idea. And innovation is a state of mind. Innovation is a state of mind. It's not required that you have to be proper for doing innovation, or you have to get the degree to do the innovation. Innovation may happen by anyone, any school student or a person who is living in the rural area. They are also having innovative minds, and they are also solving their problems with some kind of ideas generation and solving their problem with innovation. Okay, so it is a state of mind. So don't think that I should be academically very good to do the innovation, or I should be the topper. Anyone can do the innovation. You just have to cultivate the habit of thinking around and identifying the problems and converting the and a passion to solve the problem. And then once you understand what is to be solved, what is your problem that you want to solve, and then how to solve will come automatically. You will explore and you will find out, and then you will be able to solve the problems. I think if I start answering the questions, then it will be difficult for me to conduct the session only. So is it okay? I will take all the questions at the end.
Yes, ma'am. You take the questions at the end.
Okay. So Parvinder, I'll remind you, write down in the chat. I'll answer your question. So it's a journey towards creating the value. And who is going to do this journey? Who is going to do this journey? So there are some agents of innovations. Who are they? They are the managers of growing organizations. So it is not necessary that only the entrepreneur or the startup or founder are going to do the innovation. Innovation is done by each and everyone. As a teacher, as a IIC president, or as a NISP coordinator, we are every year we are going to innovate, and we are doing it better and better. And that is also called as innovation. So innovation is done by the managers of growing organization. It is very important that the higher level CEO of the organization or the executive managers are innovative. It is very, very important. Otherwise, the organization will fail. in order to grow for any organization, that person should have the capacity of being innovative. So that's why whatever choice you are having in your mind by like doing management or going for the placement or going for the higher studies or building your own business, it is very, very important that you have to have the innovative mindset. So this innovation is done by the managers, social innovators who are helping the society, or entrepreneurs, they are bringing the business by identifying some problem, solving the problem, bringing a new product, then removing the problems of the old product and creating a new product or totally new product, or a startup founders or the change maker in any organization, all are innovators. And so these below every slide, I'm just writing what is innovation. What is innovation? Okay, these are many definitions of innovations. So turning your idea into solution, identify the problem, then turn your idea into solution, and that will helpful to the customer. So it is from customer's point of view. It is not like you are creating, you want to create a particular device which is a smart device, but people are not going to use it, then it is not, it will not create a value. It is an innovation, but it is not going to create any value because people are not going to buy it because it may be costly or it may be, it is not that useful to them from their perspective. So you have to understand about the customer or the person who is going to use your product or use your service. What is the need of the customer? And then only you need to provide the solution. First step is to look around, get the problem, identify the problem, and then you decide about solving the problem, and then decide how to solve the problem. But you have to go into the customer's perspective and think about it, and then you have to provide the solution. For example, I can say that now there was one person, I don't remember, I tried to search on the Google, but I couldn't find the name, that he was traveling through airport and his bag got lost. And that it was misplaced and it was in the other flight. So that was the problem. So he got frustrated. He said that I wanted my bag, and my bag I cannot get now. I have to come tomorrow again to collect the bag because it is misplaced and it has gone with some other plane, other flight. So he wanted to solve the problem. So he went behind and he struggled, he tried to find out, and now the tracking is possible. So he came up with the solution that for every bag we can attach a tracking chip, and then he came up with and he filed a patent because it was done for him for the first time. And then what happened, like it was just a small idea, a small problem, and he wanted to solve the problem. So he explored and he got how to find out, or he can take the help of some expert in that case, who is technologically advanced person. And then both of them together, they might have came up with the solution and they filed a patent. After filing the patent, then all the airlines like Delta Airways approached them for the first time. And all the bag manufacturers also approached him, and they offered him some crores of money that you give us this technology and we want to build the bag which will have the tracking chip, and even the airport authorities, they wanted to have his application or his technology to be used. And there are two ways, like they pay higher money and you sell them, or you can ask for something. So he said that, okay, I don't want bigger money, I want only 50 paisa per bag. And now so many bags are going and using such technology. So if in that case, he is getting every month lakhs of income. Okay, so what is the harm in that? But we have never thought about this. So we don't look around and we don't try to solve the problem. That is our problem. Otherwise, everyone is capable of solving any kind of problems. Okay, so it's just a mindset, and you have to decide, like, you want to solve any problem, and I'm going to go behind this solutions. I'm going to do that. And see, here there are 4 years are there in your life where it's a long journey, and when you are passing and when you're going out of this college, you should be proud of yourself that, okay, I have done so many things in the college, participated in multiple events, extracurricular, curriculars, and I've did a product, and I have got some experience about the startups. Now I don't worry about it. I'm so confident, even if I'm doing job or whatever. Okay, so utilize your time and do that. So I'm not going in details of each and everything. I'm making it simple and attractive. I'm trying to make it is attractive. It is innovation is a state of mind. First step of innovation is having creative mind. And there are terms like creativity, invention, and innovation. So I just wanted that we should know about it. So creativity is the first step of innovation. To do the innovation, having creative mind is necessary. And you have to turn your imaginative ideas into reality by combining or channelizing them. So creativity, but it is not providing any solution that creates value. It's just a creative mind, which is the first step of innovation. The second one is then the second one is called as innovation. Second one is about invention. So inventions are done by mostly the scientists or inventors. For example, invention of the technology of semiconductor, or invention of x-rays or a machine, x-ray technology, or a laser technology, or the invention of the equation E is equal to mc square. All these are inventions. But if we apply this invention in the form of application, or if you apply your creative idea in the form of application that is used by someone and creating a success, which is commercial success or social success, then it is called as innovation. So I think you have understood. Creative mind is required. Creative ideas are needed. And sometimes you make use of invented technology, like E is equal to mc square is invented, or semiconductor is invented by inventor. But you are doing the application of semiconductor in building a device or product such as radio. So radio is so creativity is something new, and innovation is implementing that something new. Okay. So what you have to follow? Like in the diagram, you see that innovation is idea, change, experiment, research, improvement, analysis, all these things are there. And what is to be followed is that you do things every day better and better. Right now, from you day one, you have to make the practice that whatever you are doing in the daily life, you have to keep doing it better and better. Okay, like improving your routine, and then doing whatever your job, you have to do it. Like doing, if you have planned about doing the homeworks or your studies and or whatever is endeavor, whatever you are doing, you have to do everything better and better every day. Okay, there is always some way to do anything in a better manner, whatever is the state, and you have to adapt yourself to the change. That is also a requirement to be innovative, and be the innovator, be the leader, not an follower or imitator. Okay. And any idea, we cannot say that it is a good or bad idea unless we implement it. Okay. Like Google people, they thought, other people were thinking that it is a very bad idea to crawl the internet and then store it in a machine. It was a bad idea, but it turned out to be the best idea. And so what is the harm? You have to try, and you may fail. So if you fail, you try again, but you may change it, and again you try. Like this, it is the continuous process. Like Thomas Edison also have tried for 1000 ways to come up with this invention of light bulb, and he is saying that I have not failed, but I have understood and I have studied that these are the 10,000 ways which are the wrong way to perform something like in this invention. Okay, so we are offering something which is a better product or a better service provided to the customer or someone, or you do some improvement in a process. That is also called as innovation. Okay, these are some of the definitions and some of the examples. Like every here in the left hand side, you can see now how the inventions went happening, and now we are having a flat TV. Okay, which is a plasma or LED TV. Even in mobile, we started with wired mobile phone, wired phone with, and we changed with the mobile. And now the current mobile is having the capacity of more than the capacity of the machine or desk computer that we were using when we were in college. Okay, so our mobile is a small computer with so many applications. Okay, so it is also, the inventions went on happening here. So here, if I'll not read all these definitions, but I can say that you may have many ideas. You just have to throw the bad ones, and the convinced idea you can go on. But you have to give yourself some time to generate the ideas. And what is now proved is sometimes it was imagined. And we need dreamers as well as doers. Some people are only dreamers. They only keep dreaming about the future, but they don't do anything. And some people are only doing, and they are just working, working, and working, but they don't have a proper dream. So both of them, they will not be that much successful. You have to be the you have to have the combination of both the things. You have to be a dreamer, having dreams, as well as you have to try to implement your dreams. Then only the success will be there. Or even the people who have invented something, it was not known to them that whatever they are trying is impossible. They were thinking that it is possible, and impossible changed into possible. Okay, people have not realized that they will see the person on the TV, or they will be able to see a person when they are talking to that person. Now in the virtual reality, what is possible is that when you are making a call to someone, you will be able to see the 3D projection of that person in front of you. So here we are seeing the video or the picture of the person, but it is now possible. It will be possible that you will be able to see the person in front of you when you are talking to the person. That is also possible in future. Okay, so we have to contribute. We are engineers. We are not supposed to do the work for others. We are supposed to create something and provide solution to the society. Okay, even Darwin said that it is not the strongest species who survive. Okay, you are going after this college 4 years, you will be there in the outside world, and there is lots of competition, and you have to survive in the outside world. So survival is not to the survival who is the strongest species, or more intelligent, but the person who is adaptable to the change, who can change quickly to himself depending on the environment, is the person who is going to, or species who is going to survive. That was his theory. Okay, and here I can show here one picture. Here the queen is lost into the forest, and she is saying that now it takes all running you can do to keep in the same place. Like if you are running in the same, just you are running here and there, then you will be there in the same place, in this lost forest. In order to come out and go somewhere else, you will have to run twice as fast as you can. Okay, so you have to speed up. Like you will say that you will go with your pace slowly and aram say that nothing is going to happen. You have to speed up. You have to dream, you have to do, and you have to speed up to make your dreams to happen. Okay, so good ideas and true invention, and for true invention, it's not like it's a one person job. You have to collaborate. Sometimes like some of the classes are students are such that they don't want to show that they are very clever, or they don't want to show that they have studied something to the other student. Okay, or they hide themselves. Or some of the classes are we see the students are ready to share everything with each other. Okay, they are writing someone is writing the assignment ready to share with the other person, and sometimes the clever or intelligent person, they just want to hide. So hiding is not a solution. It is not a solution. You have to interact, have the debating, share the knowledge, talk to many people, take their views. All these things, all these habits should be there. Okay, so if someone is there that collaborate, have the habit of collaborating, making friends, talking, and sharing your ideas, whether it is silly or good or bad or something. Like you have to continuously keep talking and making connection with people. Okay. Steve Jobs once said that, it's a famous statement by him, that innovation distinguishes between a leader and follower. Okay, so if you are innovative, you are the leader. So that is needed in the organizations also, because there are so many people who are ready to do the work, if the leader is asking them to do something, they are the workers, and they are ready to do that, and there are so many people available. So if you are just the person who is doing the work which is asked you to do, you will be a follower, and then the survival is difficult. So it is a need, like my innovation. You have to have the innovative minds which will improve your life. It is a continuous improvement of your life as well as your organization life. Innovation is required. You can solve your problems easily. Then if you are building any product, if your innovative idea is proper, and if you are applying the innovative idea to solve the to have the design, then it will be produced in a short time. Okay, so you are saving the time. Then it is a strategic tool to transform your business to respond effectively in the competitive market. See, if you are doing anything, there are so many competitors. Even if you are working as an employer or you are the entrepreneur, there are competitors, and competitors are also working and responding quickly to the changed environment and changed demands of the customers. So you are then you can provide the solutions in a short amount of time with less efforts. Okay, so you will be able to survive in this market, and also innovation is a powerful force behind the economic growth of the country. Okay, because if you are having your idea and if you are having your product and if you are bringing that product into the market, then you will have to buy the raw material, then you will have to employ, do the employment, you have to hire people to solve, to assist you in your business, and then you are generating the employment, and it is helping the nation to have the economic growth. So innovation is the powerful force behind economic growth. Or that's why this ministry is Ministry of Education. It's coming from the government that it is needed that so many students should have the innovative minds and they should generate the employment by having their own something business or something. Okay, so it is definitely having an impact on the employment, and then the social welfare and socially relevant society to live on. Bill Gates have said that innovation is moving at a fast pace. Okay, so like these companies, Kodak or Nokia, these are the examples. This Kodak and Nokia, these are the examples. Their strategic managers couldn't think about the future. So they are outdated from the market nowadays, because others, their competitors, could think about the future and they came up with the innovations. And here in the right hand side of image, you can see here that how the song music type of applications, like if you want to listen to the music, initially gramophone was there, then people used to use the cassettes or CDs and then pen drives, and then they were having some devices such as iPod, and now the applications such as Spotify, which is available on the mobile, is going to help you. So you have to think about the future, and you can you have to take the action in present. Okay, so innovation is about staying relevant, and for that you need to have some creative mindset. There are so many things like 12 benefits of having being creativity. If you are not happy, you will not be creative. So being happy, being in a state of happiness is required. Like initially, I'm talking about the music systems. Like in order to listen to the music, initially people used to use the cassette and tape recorder, and now it is outdated. If you are not thinking, because the innovation happened. And people came up with the applications such as Spotify by using technology. And because of that, Spotify became popular. And now this other systems have gone outdated, and now they are not in the... So if you're not staying relevant to the current technology, you are out of the market. Okay. So it is a requirement. Why you have to have innovative mind? Because you will be able to think ahead and you will be able to take the actions. And this is just, I'm showing how progress is done because of innovation in this diagram. Okay, how the progress is done in this particular field. And Spotify could identify that in future people can listen music through mobile, that is more beneficial. So they took action before other people, and they came up with the application. It became famous. So like this, we have to do or take actions about or whenever we are doing any projects or something. Okay, and being creative is necessary. Being creative is necessary. It is multidisciplinary. Don't think that if you have taken computer branch or mechanical branch, then you don't have to understand anything else. Little bit knowledge you need to have, and depending on the requirement, you should be able to explore it. So you should be open to multidisciplinary kind of work. Then creative, if you are creative, it will allow you to express yourself. It will promote the thinking, allow you to be creative. I think, who is the host? Can you check this? I am not able to have the right now. I have got the control.
Hello,
about
ma'am.
This.
I'm the host. I'm checking it out.
Achha, okay. This creativity will think, will promote thinking about problem solving. You have to think out of the box to come up with the proper solution. Once you are creative, you got the problem and you get the purpose of life, and you will be devoted, and you get the feeling of accomplishment. You will get connected to other people. You can improve your ability to focus. So many things, like, these are the benefits of being creative. So creativity is important in the education, and we should treat it with the same status as the academics. So, and what happens is that till 12th, and creativity can be nurtured. It's like, you can develop being a creative person, because what happens is that as a child you are very, very creative, but as you grow, many elders are saying, you don't do this, don't go here, there, and then our creativity becomes less, and that is not only the reason, but it becomes less. And what happens is that in 10th, 11th, 12th, we are using our left brain. So in the diagram, you can see here, there is a left brain and right brain, and the left brain, we are in the habit of using left brain if we have taken and decided about being engineering or doctor or something. So you try to use the numbers, analysis, strategy, science, and we are using our left brain, and we stop using right brain. So what we have to do now to be successful is that you have to start using your right brain also. So in the right brain, you think about passion, art, freedom, then the some intuition, and you have the feelings, and you are free to openly discuss about it, and you are in the peace, in the state of peace of mind, happy, and all these things are in the right brain. So you have to be alert about this, and whenever you are reacting, talking to people, you have to start using your right brain also. Okay, so creativity is like a muscle. The more you use it, the more stronger it will get. And being innovative, first step is that you need to have a creative mindset. Okay, so some of the things, like, you have to be comfortable with yourself. You should be having peace with yourself. Then only you can be peaceful. Spend some time for 10 minutes, because if you are lazy to get up from your bed, like, 10 minutes you spend there and do the meditation, and that time you don't use your mobile phone or Facebook or any social media, you don't do anything, you just keep quiet and just close your eyes and spend 10 minutes of time, and maybe you do the meditation, like, taking breathing in through the nose and breathing out through the mouth or some other kind of exercise, and then that time some ideas or thoughts will start coming to you. If you're continuously busy in social media, your brain will not work in that direction. Also, you can try like one day no social media kind of things, and thinking out of the box is needed. Then to increase the creativity, you have to be like a child. You have to don't think like log kya kahenge. You don't think about them. You have to, if you have any idea, you have to concentrate on that. Then you need to have a childlike curiosity, fearless, trusting, all these positive kind of qualities should be there. Happy, engaged, energetic, fun-loving, and you don't have negativity in your mind. Otherwise, it kills your creativity and innovation. And it is observed that if you are happy, then happy people only produces the proper productivity, and they come up with good solutions. Even there is some sort of thinking like that you will study in one of the activities conducted by ISC sessions, like divergent thinking, convergent thinking. And divergent, you start getting answers from the facts only. So lateral thinking is thinking out of the box. Thinking out of the box is needed over here. Okay, so what you can follow is that you can have a diary or a journal of your ideas. Whenever any idea comes or problems you identify, you start writing it. You have that diary with yourself. So there are very, very innovative products that you can come up with. Like, why not have such kind of a chair, or why not build an umbrella which is or why not such kind of toothpaste which you can open from both the sides? Or why not use the PPE kits as a in the farms, like this? Or where there is a will, there is a way. Okay, so why not having such kind of products? Okay, but why to think conventionally? You have to think in a different manner to come up with the innovation. So these are various products which some of them I have listed. These are two major inventions that happened in India, Jaipur food, and all the foreigners, foreign people also have come and done the research, and it has happened through a person who was creating that crutch for the people, and then he thought that I want to build something which is more useful than the small crutch to these people. So, and he along with then IIT people, and then everyone joined them, and then they came up with such a nice innovative product. And even the solar lamp technology was very easy technology, but which it was not open to everyone in India. So IIT people took initiative and they came up with the project, and now in rural area everywhere people are using solar lamps, and they are aware, they are educated about manufacturing of these lamps and usage of these lamps. So it is beneficial to the society. Okay, so like this you can have. Now there are, because of Industry 4.0 also, there are many innovations are going to happen. So if you are interested, you have to explore in Industry 4.0 technologies also. If you want to build something which is technology related, definitely in the projects you have to use such kind of operations. In 4.0, we are going to have IoT, that is Internet of Things. So all the devices will be smart devices, and we may be having like there are 9 pillars: virtual reality, then 3D printing, Internet of Things, big data, cloud computing, then advanced simulation, robots, communication between different systems, then cyber security, the blockchain. All these things are in the new technologies. And if you are keeping updated yourself, reading and thinking ahead, then you can find out. Come up with the ideas, find out multiple options, select a proper solution, and then make a prototype. Show the prototype to 100 people, take the survey, get their opinion, identify the mistakes, again rectify the mistake, and then come up with a good prototype, then find a co-founder, then register, look for funding, and then you can launch. After that you can get first 1000 users, then take the feedback, keep growing. If it is success, if it is not, then again have the iterative process, again modify it, again give to 1000 first users. Like this there is a cycle. So going ahead, whatever the support is needed, that we are not learning right now because it's not possible in 1 hour to do that. Okay, so like this there is some cycle, and we are going to have activities throughout the year. If you participate in all the activities, and if you decide, then you can use them. These are many, some mostly only Amazon and one or two are foreign, otherwise all others are Indian startups, started with a small idea and now resulted into big startups. Okay, even Urban Clap is helping people to get the employment. Okay, so so I'll stop now. So now we can take the questions.
I'll first continue and then we'll have the questions.
Okay. So now
can show the slide.
Over to Kranti, ma'am, from President IIC. Ha, Kranti. Yeah. I will mute myself.
Yeah, good afternoon all. I'm Kranti Wagle. I'm basically the president of IIC CRC. I'm here actually to, ma'am has already given you a lot of idea about what is IIC and how to go about for innovation. It was a very good session. I hope you are now motivated and all set to come up with innovation product. Okay, so actually this is the right time where we interact with you all, and this is the right time where you start thinking about any idea around you and convert it into an innovative product. So once you have identified your problem, one major factor what you have to find the thing is about, and you have to have a market survey. There you have to actually look, get a survey from the market whether really that product is needed by the market. Okay, it's, you might have an idea, but sometimes it might so happen that the product is not required. People don't want that product. So that market survey also has to be done. So once you are basically done with that, you can come up with your idea. We give you all a platform. IIC CRC gives you a platform. In approximately in Jan, we organize the idea competition. In that idea competition, actually your idea has been scrutinized by multiple judges. We are having industry judges, faculty panel also, and where we will select a few projects and then we put you to the next round. In the next round, basically, you are having the development proof of concept. Okay, so for this, simultaneously, we are having a lot of workshops which IISc organizes, like the design thinking workshop, then the business model workshop. These workshops are already done for this year. So we'll put you all in these workshops where you can have a very good idea of how to convert your product and how to bring it into a working model. Okay. At the same time, when you're bringing the product to the market, the business perspective is very, very important. Because if you don't have a business perspective for that product, you will not be able to be successful in the market. So all these training sessions we have. So next is simultaneously, once your idea is selected, you start developing your project. You are bringing it into a working model. Then we are having one more competition where it is called as a demo day presentation, where we scrutinize your project product. So if any improvements are to be done, we let you know. Then next is you have to identify the IP component in your product. See, it is not necessary that your entire product can be applied for IP. Part of your product also can be applied for IP. Okay. Like for example, this year's theme, I will be just showing you all our finalists for this year from CRC. They are from BIT. They have developed a smart bag. Now you know that smart bag is already there in the market. So what is new about their smart bag? It is not that the entire smart bag what they have developed is entirely new. But there are some few components of that smart bag which are applied. They have applied it for patenting. Okay, that's totally their idea. That idea has not been invented till now. So they are going to apply it for IP. They have already applied for IP actually, and we are waiting for the final approval. Next is there's a workshop on the prototype design also simultaneously for your further refining of your project. Then finally, once that is done, we are actually selecting the best prototype that will be done by our internal panel members only. We will be selecting your project and we will be nominating only a few best projects and we will be uploading on the IISc portal. Okay, this IISc portal is actually, we are reporting directly to Ministry of Education, that is at Delhi. Okay, so we will be uploading a few projects from this finally, the best projects, and we will be uploading it to the IISc portal. Now, once they scrutinize at their end, you are going to the next round. So there is a rigorous mentoring session, almost it goes on for 1 month. There's a rigorous training session by some other mentors. You're having a mentor from the college, you'll assign some other mentor anywhere from India. They will be rigorously training you. They will tell you some certain improvements. You'll be giving presentations and so on. And then finally, your next round is you are going to the national level. Okay. So our team for this year from CRC, those are the final year students, they actually started developing the project right from second year. And I'm the mentor of their team. So from second year, actually, they have started developing the project. And now, right now, they are in the final year. So at this final year stage, they have gone to the national level. So we are just waiting for the final results where they will be funded for the project. So normally, the funding which is there from Ministry of Education is up to 25 lakhs. It can go up to 25 lakhs. That depends upon your product. So they are actually funding you to go for startup. So we are in this stage right now. So these are all the phases. So from first year itself, you can start thinking about the idea. If you want, partially, you also can start testing. So one thing is very important, I told you, is you have to have a market survey, whether your product is really required by the market. Okay. Then only you go for the next phases. And then we are having the different platforms. The CRC will provide you all these platforms. And I just overlooked into the chat box. Few of them are having questions like whether you will be given attendance, you'll be relieved from academic and all. Yes, of course, from the new NEP policy, we have been told, not 100%, but you will be relieved and you will be given time for concentrating on these projects. Okay, where you can get relieved from your academic related activities. So obviously, this is going to have benefit for you all. And my suggestion is, as engineers, your vision should to innovate, okay? And secondly, it is not that you always don't think of being employed by someone. You become the employer, you employ people, okay? That should be your aim. And you should always try to bring out something which helps the society. So right now in Mumbai itself, you can find out multiple problems which are there, which you can solve. Okay. There is water problem. There is basically a compost problem. You know that city needs to be clean. And there are so many issues which are there, which you can look around and you can come up with your idea. The best thing is you go for a mixed team where it is a combination of all the departments. So try to interact with all your batchmates from other branches also. Don't try to only concentrate on, I'm computer, so I will come up with only that project. It is better if you interact with all the other departments like electronics, mechanical. So if a team is a mixed team, you will definitely be successful because each one is having a different academic is designed in a different way. So they will be able to help you all better. Like for example, if you're a computer engineer, you might not have that much of idea about the electronics part and all, or a mechanical person. So it is preferably you go for a mixed team. Okay, so try to think in that direction and we are welcoming you all. We are insisting you all that you become part of IISc, come up with your innovative products so that you can become the future innovators of CRC. Next slide. So these are some of the few fields which you can think about, like healthcare, agriculture, smart vehicle, food processing, robotics, drones, waste management. So many fields are there which you can think about and you can try to concentrate and you can find, try to bring a solution. Okay. Next, ma'am. Okay, so this is the current project which has gone to the finals. It is an IoT-based solar-powered smart bag for women's safety, along with air conditioning purification system. Smart bags are already there into the market. I'm sorry about is I cannot disclose this project because we have applied for patent. So in detail, I cannot speak about this project, but from the topic itself, you can understand that it is what that product, what they have brought out into the market. It is for the safety of women, okay? So that is one part which was very attractive about the project and they could reach to the finals because it is having a great societal impact. So try to bring out project which is having a great societal impact. And these are our final year teams. They are actually from IT. They have developed this project. And actually these all four are from BIT. This is not a mixed team, but these people, the students had a different vision right from start. They had a lot of interest in developing IoT projects. So they have learned many things on their own. There was no one to guide them that way on the IoT part. As IT engineers, some of the subjects, they got inputs from there, which they learn in their academics. But the IoT part and all, a few inputs were taken from me as I'm the mentor. But many things they have done on their own. But if you want, you can preferably go for a mixed team, which I suggest. So that is all from my side. So I'm welcoming you all to the IISc Council. So those who want to apply, we will be sharing the Google form. You can be part of the IISc. At the same time, you can also start thinking about your ideas and bring your innovation out. Yeah, thank you.
Any questions from US side students, you can put it in the chat box.
So here the link is there for those who want to build their ideas and they want to get trained about being innovative and doing good projects. So that they will come to know about the notifications about the events directly in their email box and WhatsApp. So we may create a WhatsApp group for those students who are interested in attending plus organizing the events and being a part of this council. Okay, so you can fill, I'll share this with Archana ma'am.
Okay. Okay, ma'am. Ma'am, there is one question from Mahendra. Can you elaborate more about pre-incubation or incubation means how it works?
Yeah, pre-incubation means what will happen in the college is a pre-incubation where you start from idea to implement that idea in the form of innovation project and product. So up to the creation of the product is a pre-incubation state. That means your project is in the incubation state. if you are achieving a small prototype, which is not a full-fledged project or product, but it is a small prototype which will give you the results. So to improve this prototype to actual product, you may need to get it incubated. So there are some incubation centers. So we can connect you with the incubation centers where there are mentors, which they will teach you that how to make the actual product out of this prototype, how to bring it into the market if you need funds, and all that support will be provided to you in the incubation center. So there are two stages: incubation stage and pre-incubation. Pre-incubation means working within the college, starting from the idea, implementing it, and a small prototype of your project. But the actual product will look different than the prototype. Prototype is mostly it is an ugly prototype, or it is not having a proper look and feel and a nice covering or something. But you update it as a product that you can launch into the market is the actual product. So so till the prototype, it is pre-incubation. After prototype, of startup, it will be incubation. Incubation stage. So we can that increases your efficiency. That is known fact. So many people are saying like that. So, but it is not. I think I have answered you.
Miss Tanuj Kumar,
you have to experience meditation when you are not when you are not trying to think anything. That time only, after some time, something important thought or some solution you get for any problem. Whenever there is any problem in the life, if you are sitting quietly and just giving yourself some time, you get the solution. So that's what I wanted to say. Okay, next.
Miss Tanuj Kumar has a question. If we come with a decent startup idea, will our college allow us to work on it by providing some exceptions like attendance and provide workspace?
Yes. But you have to put up your proposal and you have to be the part of IIC Council. We are there. There are some teachers also. So you will be connected to the teacher with your team, and then a teacher knows. And with the application, proper application and proper approval, we decide like how and what concession is to be given to the group.
Any other questions from the participants?
Miss, will the PDF will be circulated in a group?
This my presentation.
Yeah, ma'am.
Okay. Good. I'll talk to Archana, ma'am.
Yeah, sure. Thank you, ma'am.
So, any questions? Any more questions? Okay. So, thank you, ma'am. Pratham, are you there? Pratham?
Yes, ma'am. I'm there.
Yeah. So, Pratham will give vote of thanks. And extremely sorry, ma'am, for... problem regarding welcome speech. Theirs is also
first term.
Mine is also first term for hosting. So extremely sorry for that.
No, that's okay.
Pratham will do the good job of.
Pratham, yes, if many students are joining, that is the motive.
Sorry from our side. Pratham?
Archana, ma'am, yes, ma'am. We are sharing one form which we'll tell them to fill. So you can please forward it to all the first year classes.
Yeah, sure, ma'am.
Yes, yeah.
Good afternoon, all. First of all, I would like to convey my sincere thanks to speaker, Professor